In this video, we will show you how to create datasets within DHIS2. We will create the RMNCAH dataset using the metadata we have already configured earlier in this course. The first step is to create a default dataset where we configure the basic information about the dataset, including entering its name, selecting the period of collection, adding the data elements associated with the dataset, and assigning it to the organization units for which data will be entered. The second step is to create the sections. For each section we create, we need to define a section heading and assign the data elements to the section in the order we want them to appear within the data entry form. Let's see how it works in DHIS2. To create the new dataset, open the Maintenance app. Next, select the Dataset tab and choose Dataset from the left menu. This will open the Dataset Maintenance page, where you will see a list of the data elements created in the system. The datasets that you see here are dependent on your access within the system. Since this is a new database, we do not see any datasets. Click on the plus icon to begin creating the new dataset. Start by filling in the name. In this example, we will use RMNCAH. The next required field is the period type. The period type defines how often these data are collected and entered into DHIS2. In our case, we will select the period type monthly. Notice the field above the period type is the days after period to qualify for timely submission. The default setting for this field is 15. This means that the dataset must be submitted within 15 days after the entry period has ended to qualify for a timely submission. In this example using monthly periods, it means we have to complete the data entry on the dataset by the 15th of the next month for it to be classified as a timely submission. This can be changed to a different number of days depending on the specifics of your program. Category combination is the next mandatory field. For our example, we will leave it as none. For more information on category combinations as they relate to data sets, consult the DHIS2 documentation. Now, scroll down to the Data Elements section to add the data elements to the dataset. All of the data elements in the available list are ones we want to assign to the dataset. Click on Assign All to move them all to the selected box. The final step is to assign the dataset to organization units. This determines where the data will be captured. In our example, we need to select all facility-level organization units. Organization units can be selected in multiple ways: by opening the hierarchy and selecting particular units, by using the organization unit level field and selecting all organization units at a particular level, or by using the organization unit group field to select all organization units within selected groups. For our example, use the levels option and select facility level organization units. Then click on select to select them in the hierarchy. Notice the facility level organization units are now listed in orange as they are selected for the dataset. To save the dataset as a default form, click Save. To wrap up, the steps to create a dataset as a default form in DHIS2 are: open the Maintenance app, select the Dataset tab, and select Dataset from the left side menu. Then, click the plus sign to create a dataset. When open, define the key fields: name and period type. Add the data elements to the dataset and assign the dataset to organization units. We will learn how to change the form type from a default form to a section form in the next video.